Is your Softr account starting to look a little disorganized? If it's anything like mine, you've got all kinds of web applications floating around. What's live, not live, in production? What is currently scrapped? It can be a little overwhelming. Well, in this video, I'm gonna be breaking down Workspaces, hopefully learning myself how I can start getting a little bit more organized inside of Softr. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner at Gap Consulting, and we make it our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. Now, Softr is at the front end of no-code tools in 2023, and we are very excited about our partnership with them because what they allow you to do is to create a front-end interface for your underlying data in no code. So you could keep your information, all of your data can live in Airtable, can live in Google Sheets, wherever you want to keep it. And you can build a front end interface on Softr so that people can access that information through your customized web application that you build. It is great as a way of giving specific permissions to people to only see what you want them to see, to only edit what you want them to edit, and to cultivate the exact experience that they need. Now, before we get into the heart of the video, I want to quickly invite you to join me for a free training. In this training, I want to teach you the fundamentals of no-code automation so that you can start reclaiming your time and automating the repetitive tasks that you do. Pick up the training at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. Sign up with your email there, and you'll have that delivered directly to you. So now let's go ahead and hop on into the heart of the video and check out what my current disaster of a Softr workspace looks like. Basically, Softr's introduced this idea that a workspace is effectively a collection of different web applications. There are a number of different reasons that you might want to implement this, but what I want to point out first is that every workspace you create is going to be on its own paid plan. So if you were to create a different workspace, you're going to then be signing up for a different Softr subscription for that individual workspace. There are some strong advantages to why you would want to do that. Specifically, it comes down to permissioning, which we're going to go into some great detail on, but you'll notice that inside of the workspace, I access that down here at the bottom left corner. I can go to workspace settings. I also have collaborators, and I can review my plan and billing. But inside of the collaborators, I can add people just to this particular workspace itself. So you'll notice that these folks here are currently in as guests, but they have not been added as collaborators to the workspace, which means that they have not been given access to the full workspace. Now, the advantage to giving somebody access to a workspace is that you don't have to individually invite them to every application. So if I wanted to grant access to the workspace, presuming that these were team members, well then, they're going to automatically get access to all of the noise, all of the different applications that I have built here inside of Softr. Now, not all of these are live. A lot of these were used as demo examples because in my case, a lot of this is done for YouTube and just creating some use cases and simple examples. But in the case where you are a Softr agency and you are producing a lot of different applications, Softr workspaces will come in really handy for differentiating between internal and external tools. For example, you might have created your own Softr tooling. Those would be internal. You could put those in their own workspace, and then you could create a different workspace specifically for all client work. So this way you can stay very organized and you don't have to worry about cross-contamination. Now, we already discussed how you can add collaborators to the workspace in its entirety, but what if you just want to add somebody to collaborate with you on a specific application? Well, that is what a guest collaborator is. So to access this, hover over that particular application. Let's say it was this untitled one here. I can click Add Collaborators and bring in a guest collaborator. So it's important to note the difference. A guest collaborator is someone who's only working with you on a particular application that you specifically give them access to, whereas a workspace collaborator will have access to all of the different applications inside of that predetermined workspace. Again, to add a guest collaborator, you'll do it at the application level. And as a quick review, to add collaborators at the workspace level, access the settings in the bottom left. You can upgrade people from guest collaborator to workspace, or you can just invite third-party collaborators or new collaborators to just be invited at the workspace level right out of the gate. So this is going to transition nicely to the next logical question, which is, so how much does this cost me? What does it look like? And how much access to collaborators am I going to get with the various plans? So on Softr's pricing, note that we are on yearly pricing. You can toggle on monthly as well, but we can scroll on down and see what's available for the various plans. So specifically, we are looking for those workspace collaborators, and it's not popping out at me, so I'm just going to do a quick search and see. Ah, it was the second one. I should have seen it. So I have the ability to add 5 collaborators to this particular free plan, 5 collaborators on the starter plan, 10 collaborators on the professional plan, and then 15 collaborators at the business level plan. So depending on the scale of your business and how many different folks you need working in there, bear this in mind when you're going for that Softr license so that you can buy the tier that makes the most sense for you. This is obviously one of many elements inside of Softr's pricing, but definitely something to keep in mind. Now, what Softr doesn't break down is that there's a differentiation between these different collaborators. So if someone's a guest collaborator versus a workspace collaborator, it doesn't appear that they're going to be tallied any differently with Softr. Your bill is what it is for whatever tier you're on. And just note that every collaborator you add is going to be held to that limitation. So if you were on the professional plan, you're capping out at 10, for example, and it doesn't matter necessarily whether they are guest or workspace. So choose whichever makes the most sense for you. I know we covered a lot in this video, so if you have questions, don't hesitate to drop them below. And before you go, just a couple of asks. If you haven't already signed up for Softr, please use the links below so that you can show some love back to the channel for signing up with our link. And also, if you haven't already subscribed to this channel, do consider doing so because we are all about bringing you the most up-to-date information about no code so that you can save more time. That's it for this video. I look forward to seeing you in the next one.